The elections have closed in Hypixel Skyblock, and this time around, we have now one of the best mayors for making money in all of Hypixel Skyblock. This may come as a surprise to a lot of people, but this is going to be Mayor Cole. The reason why Mayor Cole is so good for making money is because of the new Crystal Hollows update, which added a ton of fantastic money-making methods into the game for both early, mid, and late-game players, in which Mayor Cole enhances almost every single one of those money-making methods. And if you have a really good mining setup, I'm not even kidding you, you can be making 30 to 50 million coins per hour with Mayor Cole's Mining Fiesta. With Mayor Cole comes his three fantastic perks. The first one is going to be Prospection, which simply makes mining minions work 25% faster. This isn't the nuttiest perk in the game, but does have some good use for both late and early game players respectively. Mayor Cole's second perk, and the most important perk he brings to the table, is going to be the Mining Fiesta. The Mining Fiesta schedules two Mining Fiesta events during the year. This literally means only two Mining Fiestas are going to be out during his mayorship. And unfortunately, because I am a bit late to this video, there is only one Mining Fiesta left at this moment. Luckily, it's at a very good time, most likely starting in about an hour to two after this video gets released, and then extending for another 5 hours and 10 minutes after that. The Mining Fiesta is the most important time when it comes to Mayor Cole, so I highly recommend taking advantage of this perk while it lasts. The next one is going to be Mining XP Buff, which simply makes it so you can earn 1.5 times mining experience on public islands. This perk is great and simply just gives you more mining XP. The only issue with it is it doesn't actually work with minions, which honestly is kind of dumb. But like always, before we do get started on the video, guys, please do consider leaving a like and subscribing. It helps the channel out so much, and we just hit 11,000 subscribers, which is absolutely nuts. We are at 9,000 subscribers like a week ago. Just keep in mind that subscribing is always free, and you can always unsubscribe later if I start making trash videos. Like always, thank you guys so much for the growth. It means the world to me. Last thing, if you have any questions for me, you want to know what my mod pack is, you want to know my resource pack is, or you want to join in on the 20 million coins of total giveaways that we're going to be doing in the Discord server right now, please do consider joining the official server. The link will be in the description. The last thing to note, that this video is going to be pretty big. If you do want to skip to any part of this video that pertains more to you, please do check the time bar down below. There will be timestamps in this video, but if you're here for the actual video, let's get straight into it. Cole's Mining Fiesta typically favors both late and end game players, with them being able to make a ton of money, but it also doesn't completely exclude early in mid-game players, and in fact, with Cole's Mining Fiesta going on, a mid-game player can easily make anywhere from 8 to 10 million coins doing a method called sludge farming with a jungle pickaxe. I actually previously made a video on my channel giving a full tutorial on how to do this. I will throw it up on the cards right now. I highly recommend checking that video out if you're fairly new to Crystal Hollows. It makes a ton of money by itself, and during the Mining Fiesta, it's going to be making even more. To put it simply, you're going to need just a couple of things. For starters, you're going to need a jungle pickaxe. You can buy this on the auction house. The next thing you're going to need is the best mining setup you can get, but all you really need is glacite armor. The goal here is to get yourself to the highest mining speed possible, but you need to get 1,500 or more. Once you have 1,500 mining speed, you're going to want to get yourself to the Crystal Hollows, which you're going to need Heart of the Mountain 3 to do. Once you get to the Crystal Hollows, get yourself to the jungle biome. You can simply lobby swap to get here. Like I said, ideally, you're going to want to have 1,500 mining speed, and that's because you really want to be able to break hardstone. As you can see with this jungle pickaxe, every time I mine hardstone, I have a small chance of getting sludge juice. The best part about this is during Cole's Mining Fiesta, you also have a small chance of dropping minerals as well from hardstone, meaning you're not only going to be getting millions of coins from the sludge juice, but you're also going to be getting millions of coins from mithril as well, which you can sell for both on the bazaar right now for a ton of coins. Ideally, when doing this method, the one thing that you're going to want is the highest mole perk you can possibly get. To do this, unfortunately, you do need Heart of the Mountain tier 6, but if you completely max out your mole or get it to as high as you can, you will be getting more money because you will be also breaking more hardstone. Though if you are a completely new game player and you don't have Heart of the Mountain 6 or you can't get mole, or in fact you can't even hit 1,500 mining speed, there is still something you can do. You're still going to need the jungle pickaxe, but what you can do is grab yourself an armadillo pet. As soon as you spawn in your armadillo, you can sit on it and make sure you're holding your jungle pickaxe out. Now what you can do is ride straight through hardstone, and while doing this, you'll be getting both sludge juice and minerals as well. Meaning that someone that's extremely new to doing the Crystal Hollows can still make a pretty decent amount of money while doing this. This is a really fantastic money-making method, and with Mayor Hole, you're gonna be making a ridiculous amount of money. You can always check out my other video for more information on the rates, but generally speaking, you can make easily 8 million coins per hour while doing this method, and with minerals, I'm gonna guess it's gonna go up by significantly more. Next money-making method we're gonna be talking about with Mayor Hole is going to be gemstone farming, which with Mayor Hole, I'm not even kidding you, can make more than 50 million coins per hour. As of right now, this money-making method is the best consistent money-making method in the game, and Mayor Hole's mining fiesta literally doubles the drops that you get from this event, making him now one of the best mayors in the game for that mining fiesta perk. In this video, I'm only going to be showing a simple version on how to do gemstone farming. If you'd like to check out other videos, there's tons of videos on YouTube right now on how to do gemstone farming properly, but soon I will be making a video myself on it as well. For the gear you need, you're simply going to want to be able to get the best mining set that you possibly can. Ideally, you're going to want jaded Devon's armor that's all recombed. To make the most money, you're going to want to put all 5 chambers on each of these Devon's pieces and put perfect gemstones in to every single slot. The next thing that you're going to want is a decent drill, or for my case, a gauntlet. Generally speaking, you're going to want yourself a gemstone gauntlet or a 655 drill. On this, you're going to want to have the pristine 5 enchantment, and you're also going to want to have perfect topaz and ideally perfect other gems as well. You're then going to want yourself a close to max level ball pet, and lastly, you're going to want to have Heart of the Mountain 7 as well as a pretty decent amount of mithril and gemstone powder. Now, keep in mind, this is very close to the max setup that you can get for mining, and you don't necessarily need all this gear to do gemstone farming, though I highly recommend it. As for what you want to do this method, you're going to want to mine one of 2 gems, and those 2 gems are going to be either topaz, which is this yellow gem found in the magma fields, or you're going to want to find yourself ruby, a lot of ruby. The reason why ruby is good is because you can break it fairly fast, and gems sell pretty decently to the NPC, though I personally recommend mining topaz. Essentially, what you're going to want to do is get yourself into the magma fields and open yourself up a big cave. In these caves, you can find yourself a lot of topaz, and ideally, you're going to want to have yourself a pretty good lineup of topaz. After you meet all the prerequisites and you have yourself a good topaz spot found, you're literally just going to want to continue to break gems during the event. As you're breaking gems, you're literally going to be getting double drops. After that, from there, what you're going to want to do is take all of your rough and flawed gemstones and upgrade them all the way up into flawless gemstones, ideally. From there, take your flawless gemstones and you can sell them on the bazaar either in sell orders or sell instantly if you want. But yeah, that's really the simple guide to gemstone farming. I'm not even kidding you, with a good setup, you can be making dozens of millions of coins per hour. During the mining fiesta myself, I'm personally going to be making about 30 million coins per hour with this setup I just showed you right now. Now that we got those 2 big money making methods out of the way, there's one thing that every player in the game can do, and that's going to be flipping. Mayor Hole has some extremely good and simple flips. During his mining fiesta event, which is only going to be in a couple hours, the majority of the gemstones in the game are going to drop like crazy. I highly recommend looking at all the flawless gemstones in specific. I myself personally recommend flipping topaz gems, though I think you can also do it with ruby as well. As you can see right now, the buy and sell price for topaz gemstones is around 3.4 million coins per, which is a lot. During Cole's mining fiesta, these gems are going to drop like crazy because a ridiculous amount of people are going to be gemstone farming, like I just showed before. Since they're going to be getting double gems, a lot of people are going to be instantly selling all of the gems that they got during that event, absolutely tanking the price of flawless topaz gemstones, meaning that during the end of the mining fiesta event, this price will more than likely drop like crazy, being anywhere from like 2.5 to 2.8 million coins per, which per gemstone is literally a 1 million coin flip. Topaz gemstones are almost guaranteed to drop, and as the mining fiesta leaves for months, the gemstones are bound to go up. In fact, they may even go up higher than they are now because we've had a lot of mining fiestas in the last couple of months. The next thing I recommend flipping, and this is going to be for everybody that doesn't have as much money to be able to flip gemstones, or they want a safer flip because gemstones can be very volatile, and that's going to be refined minerals. This one's super easy because refined minerals are only in the game during Cole's mining fiesta, which means during the middle or end of the mining fiesta, these refined minerals are going to drop to their lowest price. If you invest in stacks and stacks of refined mithril, and you have patience and you're willing to wait a couple weeks or months, these refined mithrils are bound to go up in price as people continue to want mineral armor, as there is no more way to get refined mineral in the game. It probably won't go up as much as topaz will, but it's generally a really safe flip. Refined mineral can only be gotten during the Cold Mayorship. The last thing I almost forgot to mention before finishing up this video is perfecting your minion setup. Mayor Cole makes minions work 25% faster, which isn't a huge buff, but now is one of the best times to get snow minions down if you're a mid-game player. Not only do snow minions make a ton of money, but they also make a ton of mining XP. During the entirety of Cole, you're going to be getting 25% more money from your minions and 25% more mining XP from your minions as well. Though I understand there are a lot of you in the game that can't necessarily afford snow minions, drop down some really good mining minions that have good collections. For example, redstone minions give you the accessory bag when you get your redstone collection up. I highly recommend dropping down some of those minions and getting your collection up while Mayor Cole's out. Overall, Mayor Cole is one of the most controversial mayors in the game because generally speaking, not everybody in the game has a very good mining setup, but it's almost undebatable that Mayor Cole is now one of the best mayors in the game for making money, literally doubling the best money-making method in the game currently. Like always, thank you guys so much for watching. If you did enjoy the video, again, please do consider subscribing or joining in on the 20 million coin of total giveaways going on the Discord server. I hope this video helped you out, and I'll see you guys all in the next one. Peace out.